In this video, we'll be looking at how to use PHP's autoload function. The autoload function in PHP allows us to load classes on demand or interfaces. What it means is classes or interfaces get loaded when they are needed by the PHP interpreter. The only thing you need to know about the autoload function is that it automatically gets called by the interpreter when it cannot find the definition of a class or an interface within the currently executing script. I just set up a project in NetBeans. As you can see, the project contains absolutely nothing except the index.php file, right? So let's put something in there. Let's try and create an instance of a class which doesn't exist now. So we say new address. If you have been playing with PHP for quite a while, you should realize that this should throw an exception or an error, right? So let's quickly view this in a browser. Yes, so there is a filter error. Says class address not found. It's because the definition of that particular class cannot be found, right? That's the reason why we are getting this. You know, we can easily resolve this by using an include or require statements within the script. So let's quickly create a new PHP file here. Let's call it address.php, right? And in there, define a class. So let's say class address. I think this should do. Now, inside our index.php, we can easily resolve this by using include ones. Let's say address.php. Let's save and preview this in our browser. It doesn't complain again. Now, in the project, I've just added a couple of classes. I have person.class, as you can see here. It doesn't really contain anything. And then we have shoppingcarts.php, which also defines a class with the name shoppingcart. Now, in order for you to make use of autoload function, the most important thing is the name of the script or the class or interface, right? Should lead us to easily predict the name of the file. As you can see in all the examples, the name of the class, I used it to name the file, right? So you have shopping cart here, and then the name is shoppingcart.php. Here I have person, and then the name of the class is person.php. So we can easily pick up the file. Now, in order to make use of these classes, right, inside here, all we need to do is also put a couple of include statements and then say include person and include shopping carts, right? So we can create instances of those. So let's quickly put person to be equal to new. We are just creating an instance of person, and let's see shopping cart, new shopping cart, right? Now, all things being equal, if you preview this in the browser, we shouldn't have any filter messages or errors. Now, everything worked to perfection. Now, the problem is, as you can see, right now we have three include statements within our executing script, that's the index.php. The number can be a whole lot, right? And you can even forget to remove include statements or classes which are not used, right? Now, what we are trying to do is to try to take advantage of PHP's autoload function to include all the classes or interfaces that will be used, right? The main function is function autoload, right? Which gets, and then the name of the class or interface will be passed to the class. The name of the class or interface trying to be accessed, right, will pass to this function automatically. So let's quickly get rid of all of this, and let's be sure that the autoload function works properly, right? So let's say class or interface not found. Let's say falling on autoload function to load, and let's put the name of the class or interface there to be sure that it works, right? Now, as you can see, we are trying to make use of address, person, and then shopping cart, but we haven't included them within this particular function, right? We want to be sure that our session, that this autoload function gets called automatically whenever it doesn't find the definition of a class or an interface works. So let's quickly preview this in our browser. And as you can see, it says class or interface not found, falling on autoload function to load address, right? It's trying to load the first one. And then a fatal error occurs, so the execution of the script stops there, right? Now, for us to resolve this particular issue, looking at the naming standards that we've adopted, where we just take the name of the class and then we add .php to it, we can easily resolve this problem by getting rid of all of this, right? And we say include once the class, and let's concatenate it with the extension. And immediately we run this, it doesn't complain of any fatal errors. It's been able to load all the classes on demand, right? So right now we don't really have any include statements within our executing script, that's index.php. So far so good. But then the question is, what happens if we have a class which has been named differently, not pertaining to our naming standards, right? Let's say the name of the class does not necessarily can lead us to the name of the script containing that file, but then it does not really end with the name of the class.php. A typical example would be for us to just create a file, let's call it product.class.php, right? And then inside here, let's create a class and let's just call it product. Now, if we get back to our index page and we try accessing, let's create an instance of that class, new product, right? Let's run this. We should get an error. Now, it's trying to access a file with the name product.php, right? But then it happens that within our autoload function, we are just assuming that this is supposed to be the name of the class. Instead, the class is supposed to be product.class.php. One easy way to solve this is to quickly change the behavior of this thing. Let's put an if statement there. So we say if if trying to load the file this way fails, right? If it fails, then let's try add.class.php, right? And preview it in our browser. It solves the problem for the meantime. Now, what happens if we try accessing a class on interface, which is not in the same directory as our executing script, right? Let's quickly do that by creating a new directory and place a class in it and try accessing it. So I've just created a directory called classes, and I've placed a class with the name line item, right? That's it. It doesn't really contain anything because that's not the purpose of this demonstration. Now, if you try accessing line item within index.php, right? So let's quickly create line item. Definitely running this, we should run into a fatal error situation, right? Line item not found in this particular line. Now, if you look at the logic that we have within our autoload function, right, it's just trying to load classes or interfaces within the same directory. Then what happens if we find a class or an interface in a different directory, right? So this should lead us to write a proper autoload function. Now, as you can see, the autoload function just gives us a chance, right, to be able to load any classes or interfaces for which their definition cannot be found, right? So you can have a good logic in there to be able to locate classes or interfaces. Let's quickly write a better autoload function, right? So within the projects, Let's just create a new PHP file and call this autoloader, right?